Hey guys, welcome to the vlog. So I'm just kind of sitting here. I'm recording on my actual camera for this one. So, and of course, I'm having another Blanco 9 and Lancero. And I'm doing this before I go to work. And this is probably the second time I've tried to record this particular vlog to. Sorry there wasn't one yesterday. I was actually kind of sick yesterday. So, yes, I'm running off of this computer and this computer on my desk right now. And let me just show you a quick rundown of the computer. So, here's the monitor and the keyboard. I fixed the keyboard problem to get it to light up, so that way I can actually see it. Because as you can see, the letters are all LEDs, so when it's off, it's actually just, it's like you can't even tell what key, well, you kind of, you remember what key everything is. So, sorry for the mess over there, but that's, and you can see the tower underneath it. That's kind of the mess. That's where my new ashtray is for my desk. So let me go over and excuse the mess here. Mess of wires that I have to clean up. But I just built this computer, so I'm kind of just enjoying it for a little bit. But let me take off this and show you guys some of the components in here. Now the back plate comes off with just these two little screws. So that way we can get inside to the meat of the situation. So let me take a step back a little bit. Oh my god. Okay. So I'm laying down right now. That thing right there is a big CPU cooler. I think it's I want to say Cooler Master? Not quite sure. Then I got the motherboard kind of in behind it there. You can't really see it. But it's there, I promise. The CPU is right underneath. It's an 8-core CPU. It's an Intel 8-core Extreme i7. So I had to get a motherboard that fits an Extreme i7. It's got this graphics card which displays in the which can display up to 4K, up to and including 4K and actual 4K. Then you can see that thing in the background that's kind of lit up by the audio boost. That's gonna be my wireless connector that allows me to connect wirelessly to the internet. You got my hard drive there, and then all my CD drives right there that are locked in, and then the power supply down here. So yeah, that's basically the tour of the inside of the computer. Ignore the wiring, because the wiring is kind of a mess. But, yeah, that's kind of the deal. The inside of this thing. I'm pretty happy with it. You know, my first computer build, so can't really complain. So, I just dropped that screw. Shit. The power cord doesn't really hook in too well to the wall. So unfortunately when you bump it, it has a tendency to fall off. No big deal. Today's just gonna be one of those days. So So how are you guys' days going? So sorry I'm not really focused right now. I'm trying to get this damn screw in. There we go. Where'd the other one go? So yeah, that's the computer. That's the, that was a computer build. And then you got like, that mess back there, but so be it, whatever. That's, and then, also, you got the mess out there, which is all like the boxes from the monitors and stuff. So, yeah, I just got some stuff to clean up, and then I'm basically done with this build project. I got a couple of games to work on it. I still haven't gotten my video editor to work, particularly on the computer. But what can you do, really? So I'm trying to troubleshoot it, but if not, I needed to upgrade my software anyway. So if I can't install the software I have, I'll find software that will work. I'm probably gonna go to a Vegas Pro. So yeah, that's let's go take a look at your comments. Oh, shoot. Where is the button? There we go. So there's a specific button on the keyboard to get it to light up, and it doesn't start lit up. So I had to like, what's the button again? So yeah, that's the computer. I hope you guys like it. I'm really happy with it, considering it's my first build. But now I have another project that I need to work on, and that's my humidor. My humidor is not holding humidity at all. And it's not a humidity, like, it's not the device problem. Because when the device is filled, it works. It does hold the humidity in there a little bit, but there must be a leak somewhere, or there's not a great seal, because how much I should be filling it up, and how much I should be filling the devices up, and how much I am filling the devices up, are very, very different.
My name is Morris.
Meaning, I basically, so I'm like constantly filling my devices up, the devices up in there, and that's just a pain in the ass. So that being said, let's get into reading your comments. Let's see, there's another. Give me 1 second, I gotta give another, pull up another, I kinda remember what videos are commented on and which aren't, so I'm kind of just pulling them up now. Sorry for the delay. So I also got a couple new ideas for videos. Because there's something going around on
And it's for my Why I Told You channel, where I discuss a bunch of different topics. And it's kind of going around. It's about consent. There's a guy that, you know, he's from Oxford. There's mandatory consent classes in, like, Oxford and a bunch of universities, which I think is a... Long story short, my opinion on it is they're a waste of time, and I'm going to argue my point in this video. Because on a lot of issues, as you might be able to tell, or not, I don't know, I'm very liberal leaning, but I'm also not so much. Like, I'm more of an independent, technically, and my political ideology is called objectivist. And what that basically means is that we oppose an objectivist, politically, just makes all their decisions based on logic and reasoning that way, not basically off what the public wants, but more what is basically logical. So even though it may have a big support logically, it's not, I don't support it because, you know, logically it's flawed. So, like, I'm anti-death penalty because it actually costs more. Actually, if you do the math out, believe it or not, it costs more. Believe it or not, it costs the city more, or the country more, to put people to death than it does to just let them rot in prison, believe it or not. I did the math out, and I actually created a formula to where that actually equal at what age does it become more efficient to just kill them than it does than to just let them rot in prison. I got a negative answer. Negative 18. If somebody who's negative 18 commits murder, then it's a wash, basically, between killing them and just letting them rot in prison. But if they're younger than negative 18, then you're headed for the chair. So, and I'll actually, if I do a video on the death penalty, I will show you all the math that I did. It's actually quite interesting and really simple. It's really simple mathematics. So it's not like anything in college, or it's basically like if you can do high school algebra, you basically know how to do this math. So, but yeah, that's basically how I make my political decisions, is based on math and numbers and things like that. So yeah, I'm kind of a party pooper in terms of that. It's like, I have to take the very strict logical approach to everything. But yeah, so the reason why I'm gonna do this video is because while I believe knowing what consent is important, doing an entire class on it is ridiculous. It is a ridiculous waste of time. I can summarize an entire class into two sentences. That's it. And if it doesn't get the point across, well, it's never gonna get the point across. So I don't want to give that too much away on this video. Just it'll be up on the channel, on my Why I Told channel. Maybe I'll film it this weekend and get it up next week. And the Angry Critic's coming out tonight. I just really didn't want to have to edit it on my laptop, so I've been trying to get it to work on this computer. I've kind of just accepted it now that it's not going to. I built this beast of a machine and then nothing works on it. But, oh yeah, I did fix the 4K problem. I did mention it to you guys yesterday that nothing displays in 4K, and there was a big blurry issue and a synchronization issue with the sound. And I fixed the problem. I don't know how I fixed the problem, but I did. I did mess around with the Windows registry, which, unless you know what you're doing, you really shouldn't. Because if you do, you could really screw up your computer. But I changed one value. I changed like a 2 to a 7, and it worked. So I don't know. It worked, or something updated, I guess. And So now YouTube is in 4K, and actually YouTube does support 4K, and there is 4K videos on YouTube that you can watch. So I mean, it went up. So what my computer was displaying in before was 3800p, which is Ultra HD. Let me see what the display is. Let me just check the settings. This is gonna be a long ramble vlog because I can make it a long ramble vlog. System. So the display settings. So what happened was, as I could turn it, my computer, the display was only going up to 3840 pixels. And the problem with that is that, I mean, nothing was really a problem with that. It was really clear. It was pretty cool. That's not true 4K. Like 4K is, 4096 by, 2160. So 3840 is not really, it's not 4K. It's Ultra HD, but it's what people try to pass off as 4K, and it's not. So I'm like, I mean, granted, 3840 was really good, so I wasn't too pissed, but I'm like, I bought this thing for 4K, not pseudo 4K, for 4K, and I spent a good amount on it, so I'm just like, I was little peeved. And also, Netflix does stream in 4K about 10 shows. About 10 things it streams in 4K, and you have to upgrade. And I upgraded my Netflix. You have to pay an extra like $3 a month. So $3 or $4 a month that I'm paying an extra for Netflix, but I can get 4K on like the 10 shows that are on there. Sorry for the long ramble. And the humidity problem with the humidor is that when it runs out, it dries out the cigars, and then you basically have to reacclimate them. So I really kind of pissed off that like none of my cigars. I mean, I should technically be waiting on this to get it readjusted and crap like that. But I don't know. The New Worlds were burning fine without them, but the Blanco 9s aren't, so. So I'm glad that 4K is kind of it. So some, like the slow-mo guys are now uploading in 4K. A couple other YouTubers are starting to upload in 4K. I don't upload in 4K because I can't afford a 4K camera. And if I was going to get a 4K camera, I was going to get like the top-of-the-line 60 frames per second 4K camera. And when I do that, if I hit it big on YouTube, I'll upgrade to that. Right now I'm shooting on a camera that does 1080p at 32 frames per second, which, believe it or not, is better than cinema standard. Cinema standard is 24 frames per second, so I'm shooting it better than cinema standard, which back in the old day, back in the old color picture days, when they, you know, color picture came out, like, and some of the older movies, like, standard was 24 frames per second. So I'm technically shooting in better than cinema in that regard. Only problem is cinema is now coming out in 4K. Like, there's a 4K theater that I when I go see a movie, I go to that one. I'm getting off on a big tangent. And actually, I just learned something else the other day, and that is the highest resolution currently is actually not 4K. It's actually 8K, which you could buy 8K monitors and 8K. I don't know if there's 8K video cards, but my whole thing on that is if, like, 4K is just starting, you know, and granted 8K is now not a thing, but it kind of reminds me of like Apple almost, in that I'm not an Apple fan. I use Android. I do have an iPod that doesn't work, that I gotta get fixed or throw out, because it's a third generation Nano back in that I got. See, what age are you when you're in 7th grade? 13. So I got it 7 years ago, 6 or 7 years ago. So it's old. But no, it's just like the constant updates of things just irritate me. Just they already get, you're developing 8K, and 4K isn't even fully accepted. Hasn't become a thing yet. You know, 1080p is out, and that's kind of the standard now. But 4K hasn't even become the standard, and you're already working on 8K. And I'm like, it's like, dude, why are we gonna spend money? Like, I mean, this monitor was expensive and on its own. I won't tell you how much, but let's put it this way: it accounted for this monitor was about $1,000. It was a little over $1,000. So I spent that for this monitor because I was really looking forward to the 4K experience, because I got a 4K video card. And if I figured if I'm going to build a computer, I'm going to build like top of the line computer. So it's just like, it's irritating, you know. It's like you buy 4K and then the next thing is 8K, and now it's like, it's like, really? Like, we haven't even caught up to 4K yet. You know, I'm one of the early adopters of 4K. You know, nobody has, like, check your, I'd be willing to bet that most people's monitors are still in 1080. I'm like, it's like, nobody has gone even to 4K yet. You know, most people haven't gone to 4K yet, and you're, 8K is the new thing already? It's like, wait for us to catch up, you know? It's just like, it's irritating. But I don't plan on adopting 8K anytime soon. I'm gonna wait till 4K becomes the standard, and then maybe I'll go to 8K, but I doubt it, because 4K already looked really, really good. And I mean, 8K will look better, but eventually it gets to the point where it's like, how much better can it be? Like, there's diminishing return. Like, there's a concept of diminishing returns. Like, gotta get that humidity problem fixed. Next project, I guess. So yeah, I will be reading your comments. Just give me a second. I'm gonna update you guys about my day and everything. So sorry, this is a little long. And sorry if I seem like irritated or talking fast I don't know. It's been an interesting day, in that I didn't go to school today, just because last night was tough. I just really wasn't feeling good, and I'm working 6 days a week now, and I just needed just a good part of the day to just chill. You know, I did play, you know, some video games on this computer. I was able to get. So what this video game is like an expand. It's like it's a collection of video games, and my top two favorite don't work, but a couple of them do. And my third favorite on this game works. Third or fourth favorite, whatever. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's a lot in here. So I was playing that on this, and it's awesome. Oh yeah, I also got the sound problem fixed. Don't know how I fixed it, but I did. And then, so now it has sound. So now I no longer have to worry about that. And the sound is actually good. It's really good. It's much better than this thing. The one complaint about this laptop was that when I got it, everybody was complaining about the sound quality out of it. which I mean, it's not great, but it's not really good either. But this is really like crystal clear sound. It's awesome, and I love it. So, yeah, the day was quite interesting. What was I rambling out on about before that? But yeah, it's been just a particularly long just week in general. I got my the professor sent me my physics exam scores, and they weren't good. I got a 27 out of 100, which sounds bad on paper, but the class average was a 24 out of 100, and the highest score was 49 out of 100. So the highest score was still a low F. So he's giving us a chance to make up half the credit we lost back, so I think I can get up to like a 59 or a 60, which, I mean, it's kind of ridiculous. The class is ridiculously hard. I never dealt with like a stricter grader, or they have no concept of time. Like, see, that's the problem with colleges. I find that a lot of them are researchers first and teachers second. So they invest a lot of time into teaching, I mean, researching, but their teaching skills are lacking versus, you know, teachers in like high school and everything. I doubt they'd do good in the lab, but they're off. But I mean, for better or for worse, they are better teachers. So I mean, college professors teach like one class. I think my professor's teaching like one or two classes. Versus, you know, teachers generally are trained in teaching classes. Like, in order to become a professor, you don't have to take any teaching classes or how to teach or. So now a lot of that could be picked up with time, but this is also kind of a new professor there. So yeah, it's kind of I find they have unrealistic expectations of grasp for us to have the subject matter, you know, versus teachers, you know, considering like, so what I'm trying to get at is like the what they expect, like they assign us problems that would be easy for them to do in the amount of time given, but for us to do in the amount of time given is really, really hard. I don't think nobody finished the exam. So, that should say that the exam was probably a lot harder than it should have been. But luckily the class is scaled, so like as long as I'm doing consistently better than the average, I should be okay. And I didn't do so hot on my chemistry exam either, but the lowest one has dropped anyway, so I'm like, whatever. You know, I got an 80, you know, I probably got like an A minus in the class. I probably could get an A minus in the class, like an A minus to basically I'm solidly in the B range in chemistry, or I will be solidly in the B range. So I'm not too concerned about that, and I'm doing really well in my other class, or doing well in my film analysis class. I wonder why. But yeah, it's been just a tough week, and I'm looking forward to the weekend, so, or looking forward to Saturday. It works Sunday, so let me get into reading your comments. And so, a comment was left on my sex object BS video. Blitherbox says she's objectifying a large section of the population to be acted upon. She's a change agent. Ignore her. Don't be subjected to that. You know what? Lacey Green, actually, believe it or not, I don't have a lot of beef with. Because I mean, I haven't really watched. I actually agree with her on 90% of the issues, but like a good majority of them we agree on. And it just happens that on this one, on this particular subject, we disagree. Now, if you want a feminist that I really disagree with, it would be Anita Sarkeesian, but or Anita Sarkeesian, which, if you want, I'm not going to probably make any videos debunking her, because there's a guy on YouTube, which, if you want to see debunking videos and response videos, go to Thunderfoot. Thunderfoot's channel. He's another prominent, very prominent scientist and researcher. He's a very, very smart guy. If you want to talk to a smart guy, talk to Thunderfoot. I mean, I haven't had a chance to personally talk to him myself, but just the stuff that he does on his channel is like, it's like, okay, we get it. You're very, very, very smart. So yeah, Anita Sarkeesian is who I really have a beef with. Lacey Green, not so much. Like, that's the whole thing I don't understand about people in general, is that, like, no, like, some people just don't understand that, what I don't understand is that, many people assume that because we disagree on something, we can't be friends. And that's not true. Like, I have many friends who are religious, who we joke, you know, we kind of just joke about, you know, my atheism and them being religious. We give each other shit for it. Mm-hmm. So, like, in this issue, we disagree. On probably, yeah, like I said, the vast majority of issues, we probably agree. So, it just happens that I disagree with her on this one, and I just made, you know, the disagreement known. You know, I just responded to it. You know, I gave added my 2 cents in. So, that's basically it. You know, some issues, you cannot be friends with people if you disagree on. Like, I could never be friends with somebody who is, like, anti-gay, or, you know, anti-transgender rights, or things like that, because that's just kind of downright hatred of a group of human beings. Like, being friends with a racist is not a good thing. Yeah, that was what I was talking about. But, so yeah, that's kind of my take on it. So yeah, even though we disagree on some things, that doesn't mean we don't agree on a lot of things and can't work together on a lot of different issues. So, because I've learned that unless the person you're talking to is a direct clone of you, you are going to disagree on something. And I mean, even the even amongst the four horsemen of the non-apocalypse, as they're called, which if you guys don't get the reference, it's Daniel Dennett, Christopher Hitchens, Sam Harris, and Richard Dawkins. Unfortunately, Christopher Hitchens passed away. But they had disagreements with each other, but they worked. They were like the figurehead of what's called New Atheism, and that is, but yeah, like I said, they have disagreements, but they were able to remain friends. It's very, you know, so yeah, that's kind of my long-winded response to that, is that even though we disagree on that issue, and I kind of think it's really crazy that she believes that, I agree with her most of the time. It just happens that I disagree with her on that. So, yeah, that's kind of my long-winded explanation of that. And then on my Watch the Burbs with me on Netflix, Romeo Rich left a comment saying, Halloween isn't until next week, is that what you're going as? No, that is my, when I say corporate goth, that's what it is. That's kind of how I look. If I'm going to go out in a suit, that's how I look. You know, that's my, you know, I love that hat. I love those sunglasses. I have to, you know, when I'm in a kind of a, underneath those bright lights, like when I'm filming for a long time underneath those, the lighting that I have, it hurts my eyes. So I wear sunglasses. You know, quick solution to that is sunglasses. I just wear them. And the hat is for the overhead light. But yeah, so no, that is actually just how I look. But don't worry, I get that comment a lot. And what is Netflix? Is that anything like Netflix? Ha ha, I get it. There's a reason why. Which is funny enough, my film minor is actually in the English department, but that's why I'd never be an English teacher, because I spell so bad sometimes. And that I just happen to overlook. So yeah, that is just kind of how I look, usually. Or I like to look, but usually, like I said, you guys get me when I'm in my pajamas. Or if I'm in my work shirt, which is right. My work shirt is right here, so, in the video. I gotta go to work in about an hour. And then on my Daily Rants video, LaGloria7 said, thank you, Y, for the shout-out, and for the other channel shout-outs as well, even Romeo Rich or whatever his name is today. Chris, that's... yeah, that's pretty funny, Chris. yeah, Rory, if we didn't give you, I kind of grew up in a family where, you have to worry if we stop giving you shit, so, we're probably gonna always give you shit for that one, Rory, so, sorry. But, yeah, you know, when I start treating you with really politely, then you have to worry. and then, so thank you, Chris, for the comment, and then, your channel will be linked in the description down below. And then FUGrad1990 says, not the best of matches, huh? Bummer. Better luck next time, friend. I don't usually tune in this late, but haven't yet chimed in with something I couldn't let Romeo Rich, now Man Cave Cigars, sheesh, have all the fun on your channel. I need to stop calling it my channel, because it's become like an our channel thing, because this is more of me just talking to you guys. You know, and actually that's kind of a good way to think about it too. It's not really my channel, because without you guys, basically this channel wouldn't really exist. So it's more, and this lighter is running out of fuel. I've noticed that when, so many freaking burn problems. When it runs out of fuel, it tends to burn with an uber high flame for some reason. So, and he says, I'd love to see a goth channel from you one where you are appropriately attired and made up. You might get some goth subscribers too. Heck, I'd watch just to see you looking different than, as you call it, corporate goth. What do you see in like the Angry Critic videos? That's corporate goth. What do you see is my work shirt, my work shirt or my tennis clothes. Because I'm usually just getting in from work when I'm recording the vlogs. So you usually see me like that. But in terms of my corporate goth look is like when, you know, you take like kind of corporate attire, like a suit, which is what I'm wearing in the Angry Critic video, and basically take that into a kind of a darker context. Like I wear like the burgundy tie and the vest and the black shirt underneath it. So yeah, and like leave my hair down and like the hat and the glasses. And then I wear a duster as like if I need a jacket, a coat over my suit jacket, I wear a really long black duster. So, yeah, that's corporate. That's more corporate goth. What you see me is kind of not even goth. It's more like, I mean, the thing is with goth is that it's not really about how you look. It's about sort of your life. Goth is not a look, it's a lifestyle. So while at times I have to not dress the way I want or the way I'd like, it's not really about the look, it's more about how the lifestyle. So yeah, that's kind of my long spiel on that. And then, yeah. Yeah, so it's not really where I leave the look at home. So I don't get fired. It's just like, there's actually a uniform that I have to wear. So like, if I had a choice of what to wear there, I'd probably wear more gothic attire there, more gothic professional attire there. But unfortunately, I can't. Do you really think that would happen? Yes. Because it has happened. Not to me, but to others that I know or I've heard of. Of course, some employers expect a more professional look, and such a goth appearance might not mesh with company standards or policy, but I say you've got to be you nonetheless. That's true to a point, but sometimes you need a paycheck more. The need to have an income kind of trumps that sometimes. Well, hope the Sandman catches you soon and sprinkles you with disease to steal Rory's words and make heavier eyelids and fill your head with happy thoughts of better matches ahead, lots of rackets to be strung, sleep tight, Mr. Toll, Mark. I hope there's not a lot of rackets to string. Because funny enough, when I started stringing, it was fun. When I learned to string, I would string people's rackets for free, and, you know, give me a string, and because I was learning, so I wanted to get really good at it. So I'd be like, if you give me the string, I'll string your racket for free. And that changed shortly after I started getting a job doing it, and then like also like breaking a lot of strings on my rackets, so I had to string them a lot. So it became not really as much fun anymore as it was a job. So once things become a job, they tend to become less fun. And even if you talk to some YouTubers, they'll say that it's like some of the big YouTubers, I mean, a lot of them won't say it, but or a lot have said it at periods of times until they rediscover their love for YouTube. You know, I might rediscover my love for stringing and want to do it more, but now it's just basically become a job, And granted, I still pride myself in my ability to string, and I like it more than any of the jobs that I've done. But you know, it's a job. You know, it's a job. So, yeah. I hope there's not a lot of rackets to string. I string too much of them already. Mm-hmm. But thank you, Mark. Your channel will be linked in the description down below. And then, on my first cigar vlog, Mark also left a comment saying, "I like you, Wyatt. I like your channels. I'm a fan now." I don't like the word fan too much. I mean, you hear that said a lot, but right now I don't feel like I'm big enough to even, you know, that word to be even justifiably used, because I feel like once you develop a personal connection with your audience, they stop becoming fans and they're more like friends. So, you know, Mark, Mark, Rory, Chris, you guys have left comments on a lot of my videos, and you guys, you know, that are watching me, you know, the other guys, even though you guys haven't chimed in yet, you know, you watch my videos consistently, and an issue of being fans anymore. It's now, like I said, more friends than anything else. So, yeah. I don't feel like the word fan can be applicably used here. In La Gloria 7, you also left a comment. Chris, you left a comment on... Oh wait, I didn't finish reading your comment. Shoot. Sorry, Chris. Thank you, Wyatt, for the shout-out and for the other channel shout-outs as well, even Romeo Rich, or whatever his name is today. One more cigar question. What do your friends and family say about you smoking cigars? They all absolutely hate it. My mother hates it. It's funny enough, she's a cigarette smoker. My dad's a cigarette smoker. For some reason, they don't mind the smell of cigarettes. They hate the smell of cigars. But, they hate it. My ex-girlfriend, she really hated it. But she was more uneducated on it, so... She was kind of the mindset like, "Oh my God, you're gonna smoke and you're gonna die." I'm like, yeah, maybe. I doubt it, but you know the possibility is there. And yes, I'm raising my risk of like cancer and stuff like that. But you know, cigar obsession made. I mean, it's not a great point, but it's sort of a valid point. In that there are so many things out there right now that people overlook that can cause cancer. Like there was a big, I don't know if it's still true, but I read some, or I heard that, you know, aspartame can cause cancer, and that's in a lot of, like, diet, you know, sodas. So, I'm like, you know... And if that's true, I'm really screwed. But, you know, there's people out there who haven't smoked, you know, a day in their lives, never been around smokers who still get cancer. So, I mean, somebody that I just graduated with just actually ended up passing away from cancer. I didn't know her or anything, but I mean, I went to actually elementary, middle, and high school with her. Didn't really know her. So she ended up passing away from cancer. Didn't smoke, didn't do anything, but yeah. So it's kind of a crapshoot with that. So I really like cancer. I mean, I'm raising my risk of it, but I'm not like. There's no guarantee I won't get it anyway. So it's. I kind of look at it like that. Like life's too short, and if I enjoy something, I'm gonna enjoy it. Damned the consequences many years down the road, because I don't even know if you know. It's one of those things where you kind of accept the fact that you know. If people tend, I find, to plan things out very far in advance. Unrealistically far in advance. Like, it's okay to plan, like, trips, you know, a couple of years from now, if you want to go on vacation a couple of years from now, plan it out, you know, where you want to be in a few years, like, career paths. That's kind of things are okay to plan out, but to plan out, like, oh, I'm going to live to, you know, 72, when I'm 80, I want to do this, when I'm, you know, 90, I want to be living here, or I want to live to, like, 110. Like, you know, get past 50 first. You know, Jesus. So it's like, dude, like, make it the next 10 years first. You know? Plan things out, but don't, like, plan every little nitpicky detail out that far in advance. It's kind of ridiculous. And then, so yeah, that's my whole take on that. It's kind of ridiculous. That's kind of a long-winded explanation for that question. But yeah, they basically all hate it. Besides my few people who I smoke with. And, but some of my friends are okay with it. Some of my friends are fine. Actually, a lot of my friends just don't care. But there's like, my family doesn't really like it. My ex-girlfriend didn't like it at all. So, so yeah, thank you, Chris. Your channel will be linked in the description down below. Rory left the comment on my vlog of going back to my old job. He says, it's 11:05 p.m. Central Standard Time, and I'm just wrapping up this video. It was very nice to see you. I kept watching again and again, hoping that all was all right, and your vlog confirmed that. So you have a smoking jacket, huh? Not really a smoking jacket. It's more like I just happen to be wearing that jacket a lot when I smoke. Nice, but your tennis partner was a tad off base when he used the word reeked. I mean, I would have said better to smell cigar smoke on you than cigarette smoke, because that reeks, and is a nauseating odor, with the emphasis on odor. And it probably comes as no surprise to you, but I like to smell cigars leave on us in our car and in our living space. I hope you enjoy the returning to your old job. Anyway, it was great to see you in a different sort of setting here instead of your usual couch. You still remain a serious favorite. Glad I chose to click on Y2 once more before logging off for the night. Happy Wednesday, Rory. That's just so nice. Oh, you guys are so nice. It sucks because I the most I can say is that I'm really, really appreciative of the comments that you guys give me, and like that, it never feels like enough. You always, it's like crap, I can't like reciprocate that feeling. you know, adequately. It sucks. Yeah, this cigar is not burning well, particularly at all. Mostly because of the damn humidor problem. You know, it was very interesting. Like, I just asked him how he knew that I smoked, and he's like, yeah, it's because you smell. I'm like, oh, so yeah, it's whatever, you know, people are gonna have different opinions on it. I disagree, I like the smell too, so. And then Epigrad of 1990 says, I hope that you're enjoying going back to your old job and it works out okay. It should. Thing not burning well at all. It's not burning well at all. I'm gonna try something. Phone's going off. Okay. I wanted to just remove a lot of the poor burning stuff at the beginning. Because it was tunneling a little bit, which is my fault. Come on. Yeah. Thank you for the comments, Rory. Oh, yeah, sorry, just sending a text to that guy, to the person. So you smoke a lot in that jacket, huh? And your teammate had an issue with you reeking of cigars. No, he didn't really have an issue with it. It was just kind of like a matter of fact kind of comment. So. Yeah, it wasn't really an issue. He said maybe you should have offered him a cigar, invited him to go off somewhere and smoke. Maybe he'd come to find out just how incredible cigars are. Maybe. But I doubt it. And your professor had too had a problem with you smoking it. And being a student athlete. It was another one of those matter of fact kind of things. So it wasn't really an issue. And he said, would she have preferred you smoked weed instead? I would have politely told him I'm of legal age. I can attest to cigarette smoking is on people, but there's a big difference between the two. I'd much rather smell cigars on someone than cigarettes. Same. I smoked all while I was in college and on campus too, and I didn't hesitate to let my opinion be known to those who objected. Yeah, it's kind of strange. that, you know, like I said, it was one of the more matter of fact things. It wasn't really that big of a deal. So, yeah. So, I mean, there's some people who have issues with it, which, yeah, you just kind of tell them to, you know, fuck off. But, you know, if you're outdoors and there's no risk to them and they're still giving you shit for it, then it's really them just trying to find something to complain about. So, whatever. you just ignore them. I too like the different setting in this video. Your couch is lounging is very laid back, and well, and I like that. But you sitting at your desk seems to be a welcome change. Yeah, I mean, I really like this desk. I mean, if you saw my apartment tour, you will have seen a foosball table in my apartment, which is where this new desk is. I moved the foosball table into that room over there, which is kind of the laundry room, and then I put this desk here. So I'm really kind of enjoying using the desk. So, I hope your day went better with no car issues. Yeah, that would be nice. Thanks for the vlog tonight, Mark. I don't think I'll ever get through a car without issues. I've gone through more cars. I just have the shittiest kind of luck with cars. Like, I've never totaled a car. But I've just had shit luck. I've always bought kind of, not clunkers, well, clunkers, because my truck, I used to own a big F-150 pickup truck, and I will see if I can find a picture that I can edit into the vlog, probably somewhere around here. I'll put a picture of it. And I love that truck. I loved big trucks. I want to get another truck, but right now it's just, with all the commuting, it's not really practical. And I used to, you know, I worked on it, like, the picture you see, it has a cap on it, it has the 4x4 stickers on it, but I put the 4x4 stickers on it, I put the cap on it, I put, there's roof racks that were actually on it that aren't on it in the picture, because I took them off when I went to take the picture. But, yeah, it's, I love that thing, it was my first vehicle, But yeah, I when I got that the truck home, immediately when I got it home, the check engine light came on. Once again, you know what? My best advice, if you guys have kids out there, and they're getting their first car, even though dealers are more expensive, buy from a dealer. Don't buy from a private seller, because you really have no protection when you buy from a private seller. So this thing, the check engine light turned on. It was not, just wasn't good. So, that cost $600 to fix because it was a catalytic converter problem. It actually cost more than $600 because I used to take it to a mechanic. It's a Ford mechanic. He went to school for Ford. That's what he specialized in. And I went to him. He thought, oh, it's a spark plug. Oh, it's this. It's this. It's this. You know, I bring it in. He's like, it's a spark plug. Fix the spark plug. Problem came back. Oh, it's this. Fix that. Oh, now it's, you know, came back on. No, now it's this. I took it to this mechanic who's down the street. I don't know what his education is on it, but he's a lot older. Like, the mechanic that I brought it to was kind of a younger guy. But this mechanic is a lot older. He's probably in his 50s or 40s, late 40s, early 50s. And he's like, oh yeah, I see this problem all the time. It's a very common problem in Fords. Fixed it. Didn't have an issue for a while. Then unfortunately the head gasket blew on it. And unfortunately decided to, yeah. So the head gasket blew on it, and then eventually that was the end of the truck. And I sold it to some guy for $600. So then I went to this Ford Focus that I have, and the transmission went, and then tire, and then the transmission's not really good again, which is fine because it's under warranty with a company that fixed it. They didn't do a good job, so I'm gonna probably bring it back to them and say, hey, you guys screwed up, because it's still not going into third gear that well. So I'm like, and I have a feeling they didn't replace the transmission like I thought they did, and they just fixed it. So, but whatever. Oh, and then on top of that, I almost got into an accident the other day, because being in this area and being in Boston, I swear to God, attracts the dumbest drivers I've ever seen. Oh, that actually, I got some good flavors out of. But what I mean by that is, like, yeah, this vlog has been going on for a while. But let me just tell you this quick story. What happened was that the lady wasn't paying attention, and I'm passing her on the left, passing her by a good maybe 15, 20 miles an hour. And she jumps over into my lane. Like it wasn't like jump over up here and slow down. It was jump over as I'm like level, almost level with her car. So like I got half my car in her path of her coming into the lane. So I have to slam on my brakes. I mean, there was no like gently slowing down. There was smoke coming off the tires. There was, you know, there was slight fishtailing. And, like, that lady nearly freaking took me out. So I was not too happy with that. A lot of words that shouldn't be said around small children was said in that car that day. So yeah, I was kind of not happy with that. So yeah, and the problem with that is, like, you can't swerve to get out of the way. Like, the best you can do is hit your brakes, because when you hit your brakes that speed, and I don't have ABS in my car, so, like, they was sliding and they were fishtailing, and if I tried to, like, swerve also to get out of her way while hitting the brakes, not only would I have swerved into a lane with another potential car in it, but also I think if I tried to get into that lane with the tires squealing the way they were, I would have probably spun out or something like that. So, yeah, basically I hit the brakes, kind of hope for the best. Luckily I didn't hit her, I came really, really close, still, but, there was really, literally nothing I would have done. She would have definitely been at fault for that, but it would have just been like another thing. So, and no blinker. Wait, no, was it? There might have been a blinker, but she jumped over just as I was passing her, so there really blinker didn't matter. Because I was there anyway. And by the time she turned the blinker on, it wasn't. I was already, like, up alongside the car anyway, so it was like, pay attention! I mean, she wasn't. I don't think she was. I didn't get a good look to see what she was doing when it happened, but, like, texting while driving, you know, people make a big deal out of it, which, know, I'm not gonna lie and say I don't